The art history department at Concordia University is situated in a very large and dynamic faculty of fine arts. And so that gives us the opportunity to be in the very midst of people who are making art.
Having the art history classes inside the buildings where, you know, the studio artists and the digital artists are all working gives them a chance to see that work and write about that work if they want.
There's a tremendous amount of flexibility and really originality in terms of the courses that we teach. We have courses that deal with European art, Canadian, Montreal, Quebec art, Islamic art and architecture.
We cover the full gamut, really, of historical, modern, and contemporary periods. But at the same time, we really are concerned with what is out there today.
From web art, and iPod art to art in Second Life.
You're not just hearing about art that happened in the past, you're really seeing people's ongoing engagements with art all around you.
Taking a class right now on architecture and urbanism, every Friday we go out and we take a walk and we look at Montreal.
It's not looking just at the past, but it's looking at the future by looking at the past and how they are interlinked.
Throughout your studies, you also get great opportunities to make connections through internships.
I had three work terms, one for a festival, one for a museum, and another for a gallery.
All of the colleagues that I work with, I know they like teaching. They like sharing their knowledge, knowledge that they've gained as students themselves, but also knowledge that they've gained doing their own research. That keeps our teaching up to date and rigorous. And informed.
Students who are in the program, in the art history program, have an opportunity to see their professors working in the real curatorial world. I organize something called Speaking of Photography, and I'm bringing in 5 speakers a year. All of these people are supplementing and sometimes contradicting what I'm doing in the classroom.
We believe in a very strong, positive, creative rapport with the students.
Some of us are writing books. We're all producing articles. Many of the members of the department are curating exhibitions.
If you look at Canadian art history community as a whole, it's their names that pop up continuously.
The city of Montreal is our museum.
We're surrounded at Concordia by a beautiful city, a vibrant city, a city that's in fact full of difference. And this is also something that makes it unique.
We have students who come here and thoroughly fall in love with the city because they see that it's so crucial in terms of their own cultural development.
It's a laboratory in itself, and we can see evolution in real time, and that's really fun.
It's an urban campus, you're downtown, you're down the street from the Museum of Fine Arts, the Center for Contemporary Art, and we are 5 minutes away from the Canadian Center for Architecture.
There are literally dozens of artist-run centers and small galleries, and a lot of organizations, many of which are run by students, in fact.
We have this fabulous student-run festival called Art Matters. Art Matters matters not just to the producers of the art, but also to the curators who are asked to organize the exhibitions, write about them, install them.
Everyone curates. There's 15 shows, 30 curators, more than 90 artists.
So the students are not just there to listen and to learn, but they are contributing to the knowledge and they are raising the level of the knowledge, and that's very, very important.
A very, very unusual enterprise at the undergraduate level. It's a peer-reviewed journal in which you might publish an essay that you had written for a class or an exhibition review.
It's not just about what happens in the classroom. There's a lot more that goes on that Concordia contributes to the Canadian art history community.
There's a wealth of information, not just in the libraries and the museums here, but within the department itself that students can use to do first-hand, primary source-based research for their undergraduate projects and begin to learn the process, not just about what art history is, but what art historians do and begin to see themselves as art historians themselves.